If you're an American, or a Canadian, or Aussie of Irish Catholic descent like me, you've probably hit a wall once you reach your ancestors in Ireland. When Conan O'Brien had Who Do You Think You Are producer Lisa Kudrow as a guest on a show in 2015, Kudrow said, "Irish ancestry is tough because y'all have the same name." And she wasn't joking. Take one of the most common surnames in Ireland, Byrne. It wasn't just the fifth most common surname in 1891, but the entire clan is centered on the east coast around Dublin. I'm Mike O'Neill, and I'm a big data professional and amateur genealogist who has made tons of mistakes since I picked up genealogy as a hobby in 2011. I want to help you avoid some of my mistakes. Before we get to surnames, if you didn't already know, the biggest challenge in Irish Catholic genealogy is the lack of a census before 1901. It's not that the English didn't take a census of their subject, Roman Catholic population. They did. But during the Irish Civil War, in late June and early July of 1922, pro- and anti-treaty forces clashed around a Dublin government building complex, the Four Courts. As part of the fighting, the Irish Public Records Office, including the entirety of the 1841 to 1891 census, along with nearly 1,000 years of other Irish records, went up in flames. Anyway, back to surnames. In 1894, the Registrar General of Ireland, Sir Robert E. Matheson, tabulated surnames from the 1891 census and published a special report on surnames in Ireland. The top 50 surnames in Ireland amounted to 22.4% of the population. In comparison, in England, the top 50 surnames amounted to 17.8% of the population. Scotland was worse, though, with the top 50 accounting for over 28% of the population. Surnames in Ireland also tended to be concentrated in particular areas. Rathison also looked at surnames from birth records in 1890 to show where. For example, 78% of Murphys, the most common name in Ireland in 1891, were all in the southern half of Ireland. Pick any surname in Ireland, and you'll probably see similar results. The Gallagher surname, concentrated in County Donegal, is fairly common around northwestern Ireland. O'Neill is more distributed, with three concentrations, one in Ulster in the north, a second around Dublin, and a third in County Cork. And Kelly appears just about everywhere. Catholic forenames were also heavily reused. In a study examining how Irish immigrants to England stopped using traditional Roman Catholic Irish names for their English-born children, 11% of first-generation Irish males in England in 1881 were named Patrick, while 9% of females were named Bridget. To sum it up, if you've got a Patrick Murphy or a Bridget Gallagher or a Mary O'Neill in your family tree, it's a safe bet there will be at least one other person with the same name, about the same age, in the county that you're searching in.